graduated from Zai University in 2010 in a point in the art and design college. So I'll be talking right now about painting underwater. So I started at the beginning inspired by my grandfather. While I was sitting with him, he was talking about an incident that happened just dark, but it got sunk maybe more than 50 years ago. And he told me that how he survived this incident and how what happened exactly. So I got the idea, why not go dive there and explore that area and create the artworks underwater? So that's where the idea took off. Now, how could I select the right art supplies to be able to create the works? It's underwater, and I need something that's waterproof, that would last long. So I kept exploring, and then decided to use oil colors as my medium, and oil pastels as well, to be able to sketch the idea first for applying the oil colors on. So I used canvases, like stretched canvases, on a wooden frame. You might ask, why did I select that to be able to create the artworks underwater? Because it's really hard to be able to paint while you're underwater and the currents. So I needed something that is stretched, easy, light, easy to move around. So I selected that medium. Now, to take that medium underwater, I need to coat it. So there is a special medium that is waterproof, heatproof, and against UV light that I was able to find. It's usually used for the exterior buildings. I coated it like using two coats, waiting for it to dry overnight for every coat. Usually you find that in Ace Hardware, if you would like to try it out. Now, I had to test the person at top. So I filled the tub with water, and I placed the canvas inside, and I tested the colors out to see how it's going to turn out. I started to practice my strokes, and to make sure that, how can I control the color underwater and get out the results that I was looking for. Now, when I started to take the scuba diving license, I started in a swimming pool to be able to know how to use the oxygen masks and all the rest of the equipment, how to stabilize myself. And after that, I started to go to do it in the sea. After I practiced even in the swimming pool right after the tub. So there where it became more interesting.
So basically you did all of this for the...
Just to create the artworks underwater. Yeah.
So you didn't know how to dive before?
No, I had to go through all of this journey just to create the works underwater. So... The interesting part in here, sometimes while I would hop off the boat, I end up with a school of jellyfish. I would just hop on them by mistake because I really don't know what's underwater while I'm hopping off. Sometimes I end up with a group of sharks. So, yeah.
Everybody's surprised.
The shark or small?
The small one. Now, balancing while creating the artwork, I tried different positions to be able to see how I could be able to create the artwork and stabilizing my hand and everything. I thought that like the best way was sitting in this position on my knees. It was the easiest compared to the rest. Now, in some scenarios, I do get a little bit distracted having like some fish passing by or a turtle, or I try as much as you can to be focused. So right here, I was using the oil pastel, sketching everything out, and working for so long that with the currents, sometimes it's not very comfortable.
بنت الإمارات الستر والإرادة تعطي وترفع بالوفاء مجتمعها دون الصدارة والعطاء والريادة أكبر حواجز دربها ما منعها تتقدم صفوف الشرف والقيادة حب الوطن على التميز دفعها وتغوص في قاع البحور وحصادة حب التعلم للغواصة دفعها تقوى إذا زاد التحدي زيادة ما يعترف بالمستحيلة سنعها وهدت نساء بلاد زايد قلادة ترسم تحت قاع البحر من ولعها شعار للمرأة وحب الريادة اللي تشرف بالعطاء مجتمعها.